nice crew, where you at? Let's get tuned in. I'm coming at y'all with Skylar Gray, Polo G, Mozzie, and Eminem. What, last one standing? Like, I did not know this was out. I don't know if it's old. It say a week later. I don't know if this is old. I'm very excited to hear this song. I'm very excited. You got Skylar Gray and Eminem on the same song. That's already goated as is. Then you got Polo G and Mozzie who be talking to him. I'm very excited for this song, so I'm not gonna do too much talking. Just know Eminem the GOAT. I'm gonna have reactions of his old music on here. Some of my favorites, you know what I'm saying? He the GOAT. Like, let's keep it. Eminem is, like, to me, he the greatest of all time. I mean, Tupac above him. But if Tupac wasn't alive, or if he just never existed, Eminem will be the greatest of all time, period. Let's just speak facts. We're gonna get to this video, though. Oh, yeah, I'm excited for this. I'm gonna hear this.
Now you see me standing in the lights.
Skylar Gray can sing, boy.
My sacrifice. Yeah. Or all the nights I had to struggle to survive. Had to lose it all to win a fight. I had to fall so many times. Oh, now I'm the last one standing.
That chorus fire. And that chorus already speaks to me, you know what I'm saying? Because It's basically telling you, like, no matter how many times you fall, no matter how many times you get knocked down, you can always get back up, and you always got to keep going. The universe gonna win. Look, the universe. If the universe knock you down and you don't take that as a sign, like, look, you know what I'm saying? What Nipsey said: we don't let a hard time humble us. You know what I'm saying? So you gotta. When the universe knock you down, you take losses, everybody take losses. You know, I've taken millions of losses, but I still keep going every day because I see potential in myself. You feel me? So if you see potential in yourself, you got to keep going no matter what nobody say, no matter how many times the universe knock you down, you got to keep going, and then they reward you with wins because they see you a soldier. You feel me? If that makes sense, hit that like button.
You want with me on the cold block nights, now you front row for the spotlight. Now the diamonds in the Audemars bright, just overseas for a fuck flight. Young nigga on the door shitting, I ball on a Bill Cartwright. I can shine through the dark, I guess I always been a star type. They laugh.
Oh, Polo already talked. He said, I'm balling on him like Cartwright, Bill Cartwright from the Bulls. He said he always been the star type. You know, that's exactly how I feel. Because a lot of people always tell me, like, you don't belong here. You belong in Hollywood. You belong on the red carpet. You don't belong here. I see something bigger for you. You know what I'm saying? So that stuff like that motivate me. And then when I hear artists say, you know, it kind of get to me because it's like, that's how I feel. You feel me? So, and I can see now this from the Venom movie that I still haven't watched. So I need to go see that. I hope it's on Peacock. I'm going to watch it on Peacock. Let's see what else he said. He said, you weren't with me on them cold nights on the block. That's real, because, you know, back in the day, we used to be out there, and if you weren't there, don't try to be there now when I start getting these bucks and I start winning. You feel me? So Polo G already having a deep verse. We're going to get to this.
Hold on, hold that.
Been a star tight. Yeah.
I could have been a victim of a hot pipe. Took a million risks just to get to this, cause we ain't the ones that the cops like.
So
God tested me, they only see the answers I got right. They commenting all on the block, trying to tell me how to live my life.
He said they commenting on the vlog trying to tell me how to live my life. That's another thing. And this is from the Venom. This is from the Venom and Carnage movie. Nah, I just got it. I just seen Carnage, so. But look though, bro, Polo G is already talking to him. We're only 50 seconds in. This is gonna be a long video. I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm gonna have to pause this. We got some lyrical geniuses on this song. But look, Polo G, he has potential to be a GOAT, bro. Like, let's keep it real. He has potential to be one of the greatest of our generation. He keep going, bro. He keep doing his thing. I don't want to say he's going to be the next little baby because he's going to be the first Polo G, but he's going to be able to hit them numbers like him. Because he's versatile. He's so versatile. And then you got these kids in the comments and the blogs telling him how to live his life, what to do with his money. You know what I'm saying? He just got his mama a crib. He got her some security. You know what I'm saying? He doing his thing. He live in Cali now. He not on Chicago. He not in the blocks no more. You know what I'm saying? He doing his thing. How can you comment? How can you make a fake page and comment the things you comment? That's messed up. I wouldn't dare. Like, if I support Polo G, say anything, I come in flames, I come in muscles, you know what I'm saying? I show him love, because I know what it's like to be a young dude from the hood who trying to make it out. He finally made it out. You know what I'm saying? If anything, he younger than me, but I think we the same age. But he look at me, I look at him as motivation. I look at anybody doing better than me as motivation. I don't care if they 8 years old, seven. I look at it as motivation, because I know one day I could be in their shoes. Think about that.
I waited so patiently. If you could take off, don't wait for me. No days off, grind faithfully. I keep thanking God for saving me.
He said, thank God for saving me. If you got the chance to blow, take it. Yeah, if you got the chance to blow, don't wait for me. If you got the chance to blow, don't wait for me. I just had to wait patiently. Grind hard nights. I know he said something about grinding hard. Yeah, he talking to him. And it's all real. It's all real. Let me stop positive, bro. It's all real.
From showcasing our bravery. I know that top spot, it was made for me. It all paid off, so we felt the struggle so painfully.
Now you see me. Yo, that was a nice verse. But you never saw my sacrifice. All the fire verse. Shout out Polo G. I've always loved how he talked that struggle, pain. That's the type of love. That's how I love that talk.
We gotta live by it. Never mind all the ice cubes on his wrist wearing the big body. Body gun, get body during cellar time in that cell. It was cellar time, so I failed when I had to double back from them pills. Betty don't know.
Yeah.
It ain't no coming back when you tell.
He said, no, coming back when you tell. That's real. He said, I done failed so many times. I had to double back from them L's. I just told y'all, every time you get knocked down, you got to get back up. For every L you take, you're going to double it and take just you don't listen. For every L you take, you're going to make double W's. If you feel what I'm saying, you know what I'm saying? You're going to, for every L you do, every L you're going to take, you're going to double that with W's. Just listen to me. You're not going to keep taking L's. If you keep doing what you're doing and keep working and keep working, you're going to make them, you're going to turn them L's into W's. I'm trying to tell you.
Why don't you leave me here by myself and they can be lonely? Facts. I'm going to hold back on their flights and leave it at home. If you really gain and get them a chain, don't keep us in Congress. White time in the stogie, stood firm, never fought it. Brother's name from a rotor, you put the jacket on and you bogus. Yeah, big dog and they know it. I had to spin off to stay focused. Long jab on the motion, we on the bandit ship when it's open. It's not even broken for when they know
it. Don't get it twisted. Mozzie can talk to you. Mozzie just not with that gang talk and that Oak Park stuff. He can talk to you. Mozzie's music is real. Like, let's keep it a buck. Mozzie's music is real. I don't react too much Mozzie on here, but I need to start. But I listen to him though. And Mozzie, his music is real. Like, it's not for people who want to turn up 30 24/7. It's real. It's supposed to motivate you. It's supposed to, you know what I'm saying? He did a song about mental health that really got to me. You know what I'm saying? I'm very passionate in mental health. If y'all know that, I'm very, very, very passionate in mental health. You feel what I'm saying? So Mozzie real. He a real artist. Like him, Polo G, Eminem, they're real art. I'm not saying these other dudes ain't real artists because they is too. I'm not hating on them. I'm knocking anything. But when it comes to speaking to people's hearts, yeah, they'll talk to you.
Like I made it overnight, I make it look easy.
Yeah, sing
but
that.
You don't see the dark side.
Facts, bro. He said, I'm like Rocky Balboa, never been no towel thrower. Rocky Balboa did not throw that towel when they wanted him to throw that towel in. He did not throw that. They know we ain't throwing no towels. We're going to keep going. We're going to keep taking these punches. I love this song, bro. I love this song, bro, because it's talking to me. It's like I was meant to listen to it. That's the crazy thing. It's like I was meant to. I'm glad I just switched up my whole, what I planned on doing today and just decided to do something different. Listen to something different. I was going to rap to Eminem anyway, but it was going to be something old. But I had no clue he even dropped this heat. I'm glad I listened to it. This song is motivation for me.
Life knocked my dick in the dirt. I got back up, flipped at the bird till I earned
Facts.
The attention. I yearn not to mention. I learned how to turn resentment and hurt to an unquenchable thirst. And in the simplest terms, is revenge of the nerd in every sense of the word. But all you see is the fame and the millions. You don't see the struggle.
strength and resilience.
Facts.
My brain, but it feels as if I'm trying to explain it to children. So a lot of this pain isn't healing. You're escaping it. This anger is spilling. Almost like recreating the feeling of 9/11 when the second plane hit the building.
Shit. This song is just, it's amazing. I didn't even hear that last part. I gotta run that back.
I rack my brain, but it feels as if I'm trying to explain it to children. So a lot of this pain isn't healing. You're escaping it. This anger is spilling. Almost like recreating the feeling of 9/11 when the second plane hit the building.
He said almost recreating the feeling of 9/11 when the second plane hit the building. That's... Eminem has always been the one to talk to you. Like, and he just, his pen game is just crazy. Like, he'll write anything he won't put on that paper and get in the booth and record it, and he just don't care. And I admire his work ethic because I've seen in an interview or a documentary that he treated, I don't know if he still do it, but he treated rap like a real job. Like, he's always been type of just go in the booth, write it down, record it, and put it out and just not care how anybody think, because he's always been controversial.
Some of this is just maybe a symptom of having way too much income, but when you struggle every day just to get some. Escape to the syndrome when they can't relate that stems from money looking like it grows on trees. Get a green, but those aren't leaves. Suffice to say, with every sacrifice I made, it's like I gave up my life to fame. All the nights that I lied awake, nights I stayed up to write and pray. Had to claw, scratch, and fight my way.
He said, every night I stayed up and write and prayed, and that's real. That's real, because I've been having so many sleepless nights lately as far as that goes. Like, it was like in 2020 when I first started trying to, rapping again. It was nice where I just stayed up just writing. Like, you know, I wrote my whole tape just writing just all night. And I get on my knees and pray. Like, I mean, even then, I wouldn't even get on my knees sometimes. I would just pray to God. Like, I'm praying that this all works out. You feel me? Like, I'm praying all this money I'm investing in the studio. I'm praying all this time. I'm staying up, not getting no sleep, doing these videos and doing songs and writing that it all work out. Like, I really feel these lyrics that they saying right now. It's crazy.
For me, and I like the way it looks, the hook of your sky look great. Island rappers, how can we be on the same level now when I gotta look down to see these clowns that are on the ground? Bitch, I got clouds beneath me ever since I put out the EP to the height of 2003. Me doing see the struggle to make it out the DB because I made it somehow look easy.
He said he made it look easy to get out the D, and that's not easy. That's crazy. I love this song, bro.
Had to lose it all to win the fight. I had to fall so many times. Oh,
this movie look hard though. I wonder who win. I don't even know who win.
Now I'm the last one standing.
Yeah, that movie looked raw. The song was raw. Eminem the GOAT, bro. Eminem the GOAT, and I know, bro, and it's my goal to do a song with Eminem. Like, I'm lyrical. Like, I make, like, the type of music I make, like, in between. Like, some people compare my style, some of my homies compare my style to Jay Critch. I make, like, his type of up-tempo, flexing, you know what I'm saying? Like, type of music, you know what I'm saying? Like, letting you know where I came from, but I could try to flex on you, too, you know what I'm saying? I make that type of music. I try to make music that, like, you could play on the radio or in the club, you know what I'm saying? Kind of, like, mainstream. But I got a lot of underground stuff, too. But as far as, like, lyrically bars, I have a lot of that. You feel me? I got, like, a couple no hooks, you know what I'm saying? So I got a lot of music that I feel like he would like, you know what I'm saying? So if I ever blew up, you know what I'm saying? Like, he's the first rapper I'm hitting up. I'm going to try to get in contact with, like, look, I'm Tay Too Nice. You know what I'm saying? My rap name's AMC, you know what I'm saying? My name's Tavion Taylor. I'm a huge fan of you. You got me through high school. I mean, you got me through middle school. I used to walk to school every day, like from sixth grade to eighth grade. I walked to school every day, blasting Eminem on my headphones on my PSP. You know, he got me through everything I've ever went through because I could always relate to his music. Like, he's the GOAT in my eyes. Like, him and Tupac, they're the GOAT in my eyes. Like, I admire Eminem. Like, I can't wait to meet him. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just praying that God keep me alive long enough to where I could blow up and meet him, because that's what I want to do a song with him. And it's dope that, you know, Skylar Grant, Eminem been working together, you know. What's that song? I Need a Doctor. They did that song together. Polo Giamazzi, you know, I'm saying, hey, standing ovation. Y'all did y'all thing. When y'all on a song with the GOAT, y'all gotta perform. You know what I'm saying? So if I ever get a song with him, I know I'm gonna have to go crazy. I'm not stopping till that verse is perfect. Polo G, you one of the GOATs of this generation. Mazzi, you a GOAT in your own way. You know what I'm saying? Y'all on a song with M. Y'all made it. You feel what I'm saying? Y'all not in the trenches no more. Y'all made it. Y'all did a song with M. Like, and y'all on a one of the biggest movies of 2021 or 2020, whenever the movie came out. I forgot when it came out. You know what I'm saying? So if y'all like the video, man, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Make sure y'all referring people to the channel. Make sure you're telling everybody to subscribe, hit that sub button. You know what I'm saying? We got a lot of work to do. I lost a lot of watch time. I was at 4,000 at the beginning of the year, and that just plummeted because I wasn't posting. I wasn't consistent. You know what I'm saying? You know, y'all know I was fighting depression and all that, but so we're not going to talk too much about that. But that don't even matter. We're not even going to speak on that. We're just going to keep going, keep moving forward. We're going to get them watch minutes back. If I got it the first time, I can get it again. I know that for a fact. So make sure y'all hit that sub button. Make sure y'all sub. We're going to try to get close. We're going to try to get close to 2,000 subs by the end of the year. And then next year, we're just going to take off. I'm telling y'all, we're going to take off. You feel me? So remember these three words: hard work, dedication, and prayer. Take tonight's out.